Welcome to new video that is related to conditional statements. So, as we had learned that four types of conditional statements are there in C programming languages. So we start from the first conditional statement, that is if conditional statement. Okay. In this video, I will show you the all four types of conditional statement. Right now, we start from the if conditional statement. So, hash include stdio.h hash include onio.h void main clrscr getch. So here I have to define two variables, that is a and b. Value of a is equals to 10 and b is equals to 20. Okay, I will use scanf function also to take values from output screen. So just we are taking the values here, and in next video we will take the value from output screen. Okay, so now I have to use if statement, conditional statement, that is a less than b, curly bracket. Okay, inside this I am using printf. A is smaller than B. Okay. So by this condition, if I run my program, it will say this A is smaller than B because the value of A is really smaller than the value of B. And if I change the value like this, and now I will run the program, so no output is present on the screen. So this happened because here the if condition is false, and no false condition we had defined to print anything regarding in the false situation. So if will work when the situation is true, and nothing will work when the situation is false. So for this problem we will use the if else condition statement. For this situation we will use the if else condition statement. So now in else statement I will use printf, in which I am going to write A is, B is smaller, if A is greater, so else part will run. And if A is smaller, then if part will run. So now here is the output. A is greater than B. Like when we use to print the true statement and false statement both, we have to use the if else conditional statement. And if we have to only print the true condition, then you have to use only if conditional statement. So next is if else statement. So now if the value is same, like both is same, now I will run the program, it will succeed. Now it is showing A is greater than B, but it is because of that A is less than B, and this condition is false because both are equal, so the else will running, because just the condition is not going true, the else part is running, but according to the value the condition and else part both is wrong. Okay, so in that case I am using else if statement, in which it will check both conditions, that A is less than B or A is greater than B. Okay, now it will check the A is greater than B, and if both the condition is false, now it will print A is equal to B. Is equal to B, because now by the value nor A is greater nor B is greater, both values are equal. So in this condition we have to use this condition statement when the equation will be equal in the case of greater than or less than. So for this type of situation you have to use the if else condition statement. Okay, now we have to see about the switch statement. Okay, switch conditional statement. So how switch will work, I will modify my program. Now A is 1, okay, and I will pass A to switch. Okay, now in switch area we have to define, inside the switch we have to define case 1, case 2, case 3, case 4. Okay, now in case what we have to write, first we have to write the Sunday. Okay, so from 1 it will print Sunday. Okay, okay, so this is 5th case, 6th case and 7th case, and now default case. Okay, so this kind of multiple options you have to use switch case. Okay, so now I am going to run the program. It will print Sunday because the value of A is 1. If I am giving the value of A 7, it will print. It's almost Saturday. Saturday. And if I give the value out of 1 to 7, it will print entered wrong value. Entered wrong value. Okay, so in this video we have seen all four type of condition statement. So just practice at your home, and in my next video we will talk about the looping statement or iterative statement. Okay, thank you.